So there's the cookery.
I'm sorry.
They're making cookies, and they deliver the cookies to us, and we sell them. So they're our wholesale.
Mm.
And then we do retail. And then other things that we do, you know, we go to obviously hockey games as a group. We do fundraising events where we're out in the public as a fundraising event. And then, you know, just different activities. There's a compost. There's a good shot of our compost program here.
There's Andrew with the compost.
Yep. So this is just educational tour of the compost.
Great. And then you have this event on August 16th, the Get In Line.
Get In Line is hosted by Surrey Place Center.
And that's here.
Get In Line, which is a walk and inline skating event that supports the programs, the extra programs at Surrey Place. These are all the partners.
So the partners,
all our partners are here.
Just for this facility.
For this facility. At Surrey Place Center. And they all own and operate this business, so they're the legal owners on the business license. And my job is through funding. So they get paid based on what they make, through their sales, pay their bills, and then it's split evenly among them.
Yep.
And it's only a supplementary income, so we still get supported by ODSP, and this is just extra change for other things.
How much it
goes up. Yes, you do.
That's the Ontario Department of
Disabilities.
This is what it looked like before.
Yeah.
Before you had walls.
Yeah, exactly. Just a table. That just shows the success and the support of the host site that we have here.
So you just celebrated your 50th birthday.
Yeah.
Look at this beautiful young lady. I can't believe she's 50. Oh my! When was that? When was your birthday?
May 8th. May
51.
51
now.
No. I'm 28.
You're 28.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, she's like half your age, huh? That's crazy.
our picture is on a certain place. For an art of
profession. Oh, there you are. Paul Wong. Oh my gosh, the whole thing on you, huh?
And we are catering, and we did do the catering today.
Mm-hmm.
And we got about the time. And some people have a meeting.
I know.
Yeah, about for job coach and for us a partner that we learning what caught.
The folks who make the food from your
lemon and allspice.
Lemon and allspice.
Lemon and allspice. So they make the food and they deliver it here, and you guys then deliver it to the catering event.
And this is what one of our caterings look like.
Yeah, for the catering, our labs have frittata.
Fantastic. And then how do you get the food to the catering locations?
So usually, like, it's DTC taken,
mm-hmm.
but if it's a big delivery, we have someone that delivers our caterings by car.
Okay, but you try to use public transit as much as possible.
Yes, as much as possible. But
Paul, you're eating a zero-waste lunch today.
Yep.
You have no garbage. From your lunch.
Yeah, I got no garbage. Yeah.
He's very.
I use a Tupperware.
Mm-hmm.
And from Hong Kong.
Very cool little Tupperware containers there for two different dishes.
Yeah.
Individual lids.
Small cutlery. This is a holder.
Cutlery holder. It's got a spoon there.
Yeah.
Water bottle.
Water bottle, and then this is this part.
So all these things go in here, and it closes off.
Wow. That's fantastic.
Yeah, so he doesn't have to use any energy either by microwaving it.
It keeps it hot in there.
Yeah.
That's
I
amazing.
I say keep warm, gotta keep hot.
Is this from Hong Kong?
Yeah, from Hong Kong.
Is your family?
Yeah. Captain.
Buy it? Go there? Cool.
There's my cousin came. They came back from Hong Kong. Yeah, she gave me a Tupperware.
That is great.
Yeah.
Me also came here. She's got a family store. Me, lunchy.
For me, well, how do you bring your lunch? Let's see.
It may have a top of
wow thermos and then a heat keeping. Yeah. So is your lunch still warm when you bring it?
Yeah.
Very nice. Very good. So what? Tell me about this thing. What is this tiny little garbage bucket?
Yeah, well, for the compost.
That's for the tea bags.
Yeah, that's where we put our tea bags.
When our customers buy tea, they usually put it in this little bag here.
Okay.
This little garbage bag. And we collect it and throw it into the compost.
Okay.
But this is also the garbage cans in all the offices in this building, right?
Yeah.
So they like our compost because then they don't have to fill up the garbage can.
So the people in their offices only have a garbage can this big?
Yes, correct.
How did that come to be?
More conscious about recycling. So this building, when we started, was only 25% recyclable, and once we introduced our compost, it's now 99% recyclable. So the amount of garbage and recycling is amazing here now. And that's came from environmental movement, but also came from saving money. So when the staff got these bins, and the coffee shed educated everyone around bringing in their own mugs for a 10-cent discount so it doesn't go in the garbage, bringing their own water bottles so they don't go in the garbage, or the recycling, and just ways to prevent from adding to this garbage. So these guys obviously do it themselves, and so they taught the staff how to do recycling and be conscious of consuming waste.
Tell me about this car and what it's used for.
Well, when a custom, like usually our staff here,
mm-hmm.
like people who work here, are like too busy to like even come down here to pay us a visit, so they're usually hungry like. So what we usually do is every hour, we load up the cart with like all of our goodies,
mm-hmm.
and then we go up and down on all the floors. So instead of them coming to us, we're coming to them, like the coffee shed on wheels.
Mm. And then you ask them, as I understand it, if they have any compost while you're there?
Yep.
So that's extra reminding them every day to dump their compost, and you collect it?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Do you have a bin? Is there anything in the bin? The compost bin on the curb?
No.
No, it's empty today.
Yes, today.
That's usually
empty.
What it's like. Usually it's full.
Are we going to do a coffee run now?
No. I just came back from one.
Oh, okay. How often do you go up?
Every hour. Paul? You can back me into a corner here.
Yeah, I want one. Sorry.
And,
So, Paul, tell me first. You're a big Michael Jackson fan.
Yes, I am. And I could move, I could dance.
Fantastic. What are you going to show us today?
This guy, spin, wow. And a moonwalk.
Ooh. Fantastic. That is fantastic.
What about Justin Timberlake? You got to show the moves there.
Yeah.
Oh, right.
There's no...
Moving those hips. So you have dance competitions in the kitchen?
I won for last year.
Sometimes.
Just him, really.
It's easy to win against yourself, huh?
I could dance last year. I won the mug on a teapot cup.
He won the dance contest last year.
For the contest.
Where was that?
At the Christmas dance.
Yeah, Christmas dance.
On the ground.
For all the partners,
yes.
Yeah.
They were all
the partners or drop coach.
Oh,
no,
great.
Drop coaches were not dancing. We wouldn't go there, Paul.
They were hiding.
Yes.
They were hiding.
You don't know us. They're the one person job course. It's a Diana. It's one.
Paul, did you eat your lunch, dude?
I'm done.
You good?
Yeah, good.
What's the next step?
Wash the dishes.
That's right.
Well, thank you, guys.
Welcome.
Sure.
Thank you, Andrew.
My pleasure.
Good to meet you.
Good to meet you, too.
You're getting more and more famous.